Good evening and welcome to BBC News. One of UKIP's general election candidates has resigned after it was revealed he'd made a string of homophobic and racist remarks. Kerry Smith had been selected to stand in one of UKIP's top target seats in Essex after the former Tory MP Neil Hamilton withdrew. Today, Mr Smith apologised for the remarks and said he'd been taking painkillers at the time he made them. Christian Fraser reports.
He was billed one of UKIP's rising stars, selected only last week to lead the party's fight in South Basildon. The UKIP faithful had put such store in Kerry Smith.
Congratulations. Thank you. Absolutely brilliant win.
Yet tonight, after just 4 days as their candidate, he resigned in disgrace. The transcript of this leaked tape lists a string of offensive remarks, much of it aimed at his own party. He attacks UKIP's gay and lesbian group, his bile focused on those who run it. He jokes about shooting the peasants in the Essex town of Chigwell, and he refers to an Asian woman who gatecrashed a UKIP rally using a derogatory racial term. Mr Smith apologised to the people of Basildon today, explaining that at the time he was under stress and on a strong morphine-based prescription. But his apology wasn't enough.
It's not doing the party much good, but I think people have got their own opinions of the party and of him, and they're going to make their mind up no matter what.
Oh, I think it'll put people off, especially younger people who have been brought up in a different age to what I've been brought up.
It's going to offend a few people, you know, if he's talking about things like that.
South Basildon and East Thurrock is a Tory seat and one that UKIP thinks is eminently winnable. But it's now too big and too popular to be dismissed as a protest party, and as such it's coming under greater scrutiny. Self-evident in the infighting and scandal that's been exposed in just this past week.
Patrick O'Flynn.
The UKIP MEP, Patrick O'Flynn, conceded that senior figures had known about this tape for some time. Which begs the question, why was he even selected?
The hand grenades are rolling down the corridor again, there's no doubt about that. We're still way up in the polls. We've had a fantastic year. We've won a set of nationwide elections. We've won two by-elections against expectations
though,
of Tory High Command. It doesn't help. But
By the way, these are your hand grenades. You're the ones that have taken the pins out of them.
Good morning. Thank you.
The normally unflappable Nigel Farage might just be feeling the bruises this week. A row over breastfeeding in public, a sexual abuse claim within the party, splits over selection, and now this. He's desperate, he says, for UKIP to be considered a grown-up party. His opponents will be revelling in the mistakes they're making. Christian Fraser, BBC News, Basildon.